Did you know that world-class players such as Ronaldo, Messi, and Zlatan aren't badasses just because they can score jaw-dropping goals and dribble an entire team all by themselves? Far from it, as they also depend heavily on their mental strength to stay ahead of the pack and get better after each passing game. So what exactly are these guys doing to stay mentally sharp? Number 5. Well, even though mental toughness is all in the mind, it actually begins with the body. Just take a look at some of the best footballers in the world and tell me you don't notice how ripped they are. Yeah, to be mentally tough, players like Cristiano Ronaldo spend extra hours in the gym to keep their bodies in tip-top shape. But wait, average players train too, right? Well, they do, but certainly not with the kind of intensity you'll notice in a CR7 workout. Great players know that by pushing themselves beyond the regular limits, they are simultaneously training their minds to be ready for whatever comes their way on the pitch. Imagine how mentally tough you'd become as a player if you undergo the most rigorous strength and fitness training, see your teammates quit along the way, but choose to continue. Even if it feels like it's going to kill you, it'll be nothing but beast mode on the pitch. Of course, the greatest players in the world wouldn't want to work themselves to death, which is why they use heart rate zone training to monitor their conditions and know exactly when they are taking things too far. Hey, even Ronaldo takes breaks. Number 4. Speaking of breaks, players who are tough mentally have learned to take a chill pill when things don't go right in a match. Sure, scoring an own goal or missing a last minute penalty when your team needs all 3 points can be hard to deal with. However, mentally tough players have understood the importance of not dwelling on terrible moments. Rather, they get back to training, eagerly preparing for the next match, which is definitely an opportunity to right the blunders of the previous match. I'm sure we all remember how Fernando Torres flopped at Chelsea. Surprisingly, the Spanish striker was one of the best finishers in the world during his Atletico Madrid and Liverpool days. Unfortunately, a poor start to life at Stamford Bridge caused the World Cup winner to have doubts about himself. Now we all know how that affected Torres, because after doubting himself game after game, El Nino went from being one of the most feared men in front of goal to a laughable internet meme. Torres' former Chelsea teammate and captain, John Terry, was also at risk of letting his Champions League final penalty miss ruin his game. But moving forward, he put his costly blunder behind him and eventually led the Blues to Champions League victory 4 seasons later. Mentally tough players constantly remind themselves that having a bad day on the pitch isn't the end of the world. All they need is another chance to prove just how good they are at what they do. This leads us to another important thing that mentally tough players do, which is to visualize themselves as being the best. Number 3. Now, I'm sure you've watched several interviews where players reference older footballers as their sources of inspiration. Yeah, most players have idols, but what sets the average player apart from the best is that while an average player's dream is limited to simply playing football professionally, mentally strong players visualize themselves not only playing professionally, but also winning the Champions League, the World Cup, the Golden Boot, the Ballon d'Or, and whatever else there is to win in football. Mentally tough players are constantly thinking about success, and this is one habit that drives them to put up championship winning performances when called upon. Who can forget the 2005 Champions League final, where AC Milan took a 3-0 lead into the second half against Liverpool? If there is any match in the world that can properly define the mental toughness of a player, then it has to be this one, as Liverpool's captain Steven Gerrard showed the world the true meaning of never say die. His teammates believed they were beaten, and you couldn't really blame them, knowing fully well how tough it was to break Milan's defence back in the day. Stevie G didn't care though, as he not only spurred his team back into the game, he also led them to lift the coveted trophy. Now, judging by how much passion Gerrard displayed in the match, you could tell he was the player who wanted to win it the most. This also showed that he had visualized himself lifting the trophy as captain of his boyhood club, long before the referee even blew the final whistle for kickoff. Another mentally tough player who is a master at visualizing the things he wants for himself on the pitch is Zlatan Ibrahimovic. Surely, no player dreams bigger than the Swedish legend. I know what you're thinking. Zlatan didn't win the World Cup, the Champions League, or a Ballon d'Or. So where did his mental toughness take him? Well, it's true that he didn't win any of the aforementioned trophies, but that doesn't mean he's not one of the greatest players in football history. From the way Zlatan speaks during interviews, there is no denying that he's always visualized himself as the best player in the world, regardless of who the Ballon d'Or is awarded to each passing year. Still on Zlatan, he sets a good example for another thing mentally strong footballers do, which is never to compare themselves with anyone else. Number 2. For players like Zlatan, comparison is a huge no. He doesn't care if Erling Haaland is the hottest striker right now or if Messi wins the record-setting 8th Ballon d'Or. Zlatan will never compare himself to anyone. In fact, he believes strongly in his heart that he's better than the best. This was evident when an interviewer asked the Swedish icon to name his best possible starting 11. Guess what Zlatan did? He placed himself in every single position, from the keeper to the striker. I mean, who does that? As cocky as his attitude might be, Zlatan Ibrahimovic, as well as other mentally strong footballers in the world, do not give room for comparison. Sure, they can admire the way other great footballers play, but that doesn't mean they want to be like them. Rather, they want to be better than them, and it all starts in the mind. Mentally strong players make it a habit to reaffirm to themselves they are the best, or at least, one day they'll be the best. For players like these, the only standards they have is theirs, not anyone else's. Why do you think the best players have a unique technique or style you can identify them with? They want to stand out from the rest. That's why, be it a Ronaldinho snakebite dribble or a Cristiano Ronaldo-like celebration, mentally tough players want to do things differently, just so they won't be compared to others. Now, this is not to say that comparisons are totally bad, but there are some players who actually enjoy it. However, the players who are tough enough to deal with comparisons only use them as fuel to become better at the game in the areas where they are lacking. The age-long rivalry between Cristiano Ronaldo and Lionel Messi is a good example of players using comparisons as fuel to improve on their game and exceed even their own expectations. This friendly rivalry has seen two men win as many as 12 Ballon d'Ors between them in the last 15 years. For mentally weak players, though, comparison can cause them to doubt their own abilities, even if they are actually good, and this can limit their gameplay as a whole. Number 1. With this in mind, one thing that mentally strong players always do is to try new things without the fear of failure. Brave-hearted players know what researchers have been telling us for ages. Failing can help a person get better at something, as long as the person continues learning from past failures and improves on their mistakes. Once the fear of failure has been eliminated, then players can try audacious things like shooting from way out, bicycle kicks, and jaw-dropping dribbles. A prime example is Zlatan Ibrahimovic's superb long-range scissor kick against England that left the entire stadium in awe. Or Diego Maradona's solo goal in the 1986 World Cup, where he dribbled all the way from his own half, ran the keeper, and scored. The thing is, as mentally strong players continue to make these extraordinary efforts, the better they get at it, and even if they make a mess of it, that will never stop them from trying again and again until the skill is perfected. As for players who aren't mentally strong, they'll keep doing the basic things, which is why they'd probably never win a Ballon d'Or. That being said, who would you say is the strongest player mentally? Is it Cristiano Ronaldo, Messi, or someone else? Be sure to let us know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed watching this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. See you in the next one.